Dear students, good morning. Welcome to the history class. In last two session, we have discussed about Jainism. The Jainism, which is known as oldest religion in our country as well as in the world. This religion given by Rishabhanatha, who was the first Tirthankara of Jainism. Parshvanatha was the 23rd Tirthankara and Vardhamana Mahavira was the 24th Tirthankara of Jainism. This Mahavira has given 5 O's or Panchashila Tattva to Jainism and also 3 Ratnas or 3 Ratnatrayas or 3 jewels to Jainism. He has given a simple, significant religious path to both men and women. So we have to remember 2 councils of Jainism. One was held around 3000 BCE and another one was 300 BCE and second was 512 BCE. But first council was held in the Pataliputra. And second was in Bellamy at Gujarat. In first council, it aimed at collecting and reviving the knowledge of sacred Jain texts. Where in second council, here sacred texts were collected and written by Jain people systematically. Here in the first council, they tried to recollect all the sacred texts regarding Jainism. In the second council, they have collected and written it systematically by Jain people. Here we also remember the sects of Jainism. Here 2 parts there in Jainism. One is Shvetambara and another one is Digambara. Shvetambara is the sect which is known as followers of Parshvanatha, and the Digambara was the sect of Jainism, was known as followers of Mahavira. Here Shvetambara, Shveta means white. So the follower of Shvetambara sect, these people wear white clothes. Here Digambara means these people do not wear any clothes. These are the 2 different sects of Jainism. When we try to understand the literature of Jainism, Agama Siddhanta is the holy text of Jains. Agama Siddhanta was the holy text of Jains. It contains 45 to 50 volumes. Agama Siddhanta contains 45 to 50 volumes. The पूर्वास कंटेनिंग द ओरिजिनल डॉक्ट्रिन्स ऑफ महावीरा आर इनकॉर्पोरेटेड इन 14 टेक्स्ट इनकॉर्पोरेटेड इन 14 टेक्स्ट बोथ द श्वेतंबरास एंड दिगंबरास agree in calling 12 angas they agree in calling 12 angas as the first and foremost religious as well as secular works were written by jain scholars kannada literature was also enriched by them kannada literature also enriched by them So when we try to understand the contributions to art and architecture of Jain people, the contributions to art and architecture of the Jain people, Jainism helped the growth of art and architecture. Jains built many caves. Jains built many caves for the residence of their monks they were built many caves these monks are known as bhikkhus these monks of Jainism are known as bhikkhus residents in caves so the caves are known as bhikkhugrahas are the resident of this bhikkhus so the contributions of Jainism to architecture in cave manner is known as tiger cave at Daigiri we have to remember tiger cave situated in Udaigiri and we have to remember Indrasabha cave at Ellora Indrasabha cave at Ellora and also the Hathi Gumpa cave at Orissa which situated as at Orissa the regarding Karnataka When we remember Jainism, we proudly remember the statue of Gomateshwara situated at Shravanbelagola and the thousand-pillared Basadi at Moodabidre. Thousand-pillared Basadi at Moodabidre are noteworthy Jain monuments in Karnataka. One is Shravanbelagola statue of Gomateshwara, and another one is Moodabidre Basadi, thousand pillared Basadi situated in Moodabidre. These are the monuments regarding Jainism we have to remember in Karnataka. So, students. In art and architecture, and in literature, and in when we say the religious path, which was open to both men and women, so these great personalities like Vardhamana Mahavira and Gautama Buddha, given very simple, common. Program or simple common religious things to people both men and women to follow religious rituals and attain the salvation this salvation is known as nirvana in Jainism. So dear students, in next session regarding a new religion, we will learn one more foremost religion of our country is known as Buddhism. In next session we will discuss about the Buddhism. I will finish here. Thank you, thank you one and all.